Welcome to Biomass Magazine's top headlines from the past week. I'm your host, Jill Nelson. We invite you to join us at the International Biomass Conference and Expo, taking place February 3rd through the 5th in Nashville, Tennessee. The agenda covers biomass power and thermal, biogas, renewable natural gas, pellet production, and advanced biofuels. Learn more at biomassconference.com. Drax is taking steps to strengthen its biomass sustainability policy. As part of its effort, the company is establishing an independent advisory board made up of scientists, academics, and forestry experts to ensure the biomass the company uses to generate renewable electricity meets the highest standards. In an updated policy, Drax also said it will increase transparency on its biomass sourcing and impacts. This includes using big data and satellite images to evaluate the impact on the forest cover and biodiversity in areas that supply the biomass the company uses. The U.S. EPA issued its long-anticipated supplemental notice of proposed rulemaking on October 15th, seeking comments on how it should project the volumes of small refinery exemption, or SREs, in future annual renewable fuel standard rulemakings to set renewable volume obligations. While members of the biofuels industry largely applauded a preliminary announcement made by the EPA on October 4th that a deal on SRE relief had been reached, those same groups were quick to criticize the content of the actual supplemental proposed rule. Monty Shaw, executive director of the Iowa Renewable Fuels Association, explained during an October 16th media briefing that the original deal the industry was presented with was not what was included in the rule. During that briefing, representatives of the industry were told the agency planned to use a three-year rolling average of actual SRE waived volumes to adjust annual RVOs in a way that would account for expected SRE approvals in a given year. The rule released by the EPA October 15th, however, proposes to use a three-year rolling average of U.S. Department of Energy recommendations regarding SRE approvals. The U.S. EPA recently approved a new fuel pathway under the Renewable Fuel Standard that was filed on behalf of Texmar Chemicals, Inc. and Neste U.S. Inc. The pathway will allow renewable diesel produced at Neste's biorefinery in Finland to be shipped to Texmar's facility in Texas, where it will be fractionated to produce renewable jet fuel and renewable diesel bottoms, a fuel used in the same applications as renewable diesel, but that has a higher average energy density than the renewable diesel input into the fractionation process. Thanks for tuning in. We'll be back next week with more of the biomass industry's top stories.